It's nice that the zombies have different animations instead of just one animation, which was copied and pasted on every single one. It gives variety. The guy with the blonde and black hair is looking so scared. He's trembling and is also panicking about the zombie bite. I really like this character design. It has many extruded pixels and makes me feel like he will show us an interesting view on the past. This is a really smooth crafting scene. The oven looks so boring. Some particles will help patching this up. This light setting is on point. It looks a bit dusty and gives the light setting the right touch. The night sky looks great, but it would look even better with some stars added. There's almost no arm movement in this scene. A bit lazy, if you ask me. The second hair layer was just activated instead of really extruding his hair. If you don't want to spend your time by extruding hair, you could at least extrude the second hair layer completely. That should take just a minute or so. The zombie run cycles look awesome. I like the idea of not letting every zombie run, so it's a bit mixed, but why are they so close to each other then? The hands of the zombie are moving through the door. He looks so scared and surprised by the zombie. Great job! I think he should be heavily breathing after this shock. I mean, he just got surprised by a zombie, and after that he had to run for a short while, so... I like how the guy with the crossbow is behaving like a real badass. It fits since he looks like one. I can understand if you don't want to animate 100 different walk cycles for the zombies, but next time you could time it differently, so they are not moving at the same moment. You must admit we got a lot of the movement of the zombie. You must admit we got a lot of shit that we shouldn't ignore, so give me some more. The character is moving very fast and smooth. This fighting scene was well planned. Shouldn't ignore, so give me some more. You can't deny that it's one of a kind, but it's not like before, it's not like before. I'm tired of putting up with. He uses an arrow twice, which makes the fight far more interesting. Like before, I'm tired of putting up with all your bullshit. I'm sick and tired of. The blood effects are again just green screens, which were added later. It would still look better to create blood particles in Cinema 4D. Anishri has a good rig for that. His right pupil disappears randomly. I like this slow motion part and the rest of the fight looks pretty epic. The girl clipped through his leg multiple times. The zombie lost his red eyes way before he fell to the ground. It normally means that something is not alive anymore, but it is still fighting, so it has to be alive. All the love that we have, we're supposed to earn. He even has to take some hits, which make it more interesting than just letting him kill every zombie without any problems. The mouth movement is a smart idea to improve the fight animation. It looks like he's screaming and making other fighting sounds, so this is realistic. You can hand it to me, burn it. Did you see how smooth the axe is moving back in place? This definitely deserves a win. Burn it, like, oh my god, yeah, here we are again, in the same. Okay, this was pretty cool. His sword is moving through Hero Brain's pickaxe very strongly. Every Saturday it seems to worsen. I'm really tired. He nicely recovered from this. I thought it was almost over, but it seems like there's still more to come. The changing texture for his face is a great idea and works out very well. The way he loses his sword is also looking cool, and it is way better than just letting it fall down instantly. The quiver is clipping through his leg again. It also looks like he's really breaking down right now. Reanimator did an impressive job on the emotions. He looks so exhausted in the end. The fight scene looks pretty good, but the blood effect is not really improving it. I mean, it looks better than in the last animations, but I still think there's space for improvement. This dying scene is sad, but of course well animated too. Also, his emotions. And what is Granny doing here anyway? In the end, I think Granny improved again since the last animation. It is nice to see him getting better with every animation. It was a bit short, but that's okay. Keep up the good work, Rain. Sure, there are still some mistakes which are really not necessary, but that's normal. You can't change everything instantly. It takes time to improve. I hope I was able to point out some things you didn't notice, and I also hope that I was able to entertain everybody who is watching this. Hit the bell and write a comment if so. Thanks for watching, see ya next week or so.